was tricked by the devil. I really thought I could win before he started his wis-was-whispering. These sins are thanks to him. Before I could begin, he had stabbed me in the side. I was barely alive about 3 seconds in. The doctor pulled me outside, and to my surprise, he was already there. I kinda thought it wasn't fair. 1,000 friends and not a friend to spare, but a true enemy will meet you everywhere. I lived a life of fear. I knew he was out to get me, but I was never quite sure when and where. In high school, it was clear. You could never be alone with a girl because he was always there. A third party to every party of naughty Kens and ditzy Barbies. Hardly ever needed a reason to visit me on the weekends. It feels like I could almost see him. It feels like he is running through my veins like my yawning entertains. My life has never been the same. Since I uncovered this conspiracy to keep me away from heaven's gates, I almost thought it was too late. I thought it was the bottom of the ninth until I heard a statement that Allah loves those who repent. These words were heaven sent. Even for a sinner like me, is it possible that I could be free when even my father got deceived? It's hard to believe the devil just suggested they should eat from the tree. Are we really that naive? To deny his jealousy, he is an open enemy removed from the heavenly, so don't just blame Eve. For arrogance was his felony, technically we should take credit, see, because we are the very cause of his false notion of supremacy. So now he waits for nightfall to befall upon us all before he makes the call for his helpers to sprawl, offering good times in dark alleyways and bars. On big screens, he can be seen around movie stars, throwing up the devil's sign as rock stars, smash guitars. Patience is from Allah, hastiness is from Shaitan. In the mirror, telling women who is the fairest of them all. The devil is in the details of your $50,000 car. His interest rests in the things that we obsess. And when you stand to pray, he will place doubts in your head. He will take a perfectly good deed and make it all for show. You can have everything you need, but he'll still make you want more. He will take a husband from his wife, a drug addict from his life. He will tell you that you're the man and you really think he's right. He will make the righteous fight despite their insight. He is the reason why you can't get up to pray at night. He ties his 3 knots tight, and to his delight, he will gladly make a deal with you for the right price. In Ramadan, he is gone, but we still sing all his songs. Bad dreams are from him, and he eats with his left hand. You can see him from afar, getting chased by a shooting star. He loves procrastination and laziness, a friend of an atheist. He is the DJ at the party, telling everyone to drop it low. He is the boyfriend promising you that nobody will ever know. He is that guy on YouTube writing all those stupid comments about our deen. He is the reason that masjid board member never wants to leave. He will promise you the world, but he doesn't own a seed. He will whisper in your ears things he wants you to believe. Come on, sister, loosen up that hijab. Let your hair catch a breeze and don't be extreme. Those jeans will make you every man's dream. Brother, you are so pious. You should be the one to lead. Everybody's a deviant, but you're going to Jannah guaranteed. He promises you poverty in exchange for charity. He runs the biggest, baddest gang of evil jinn and shayateen. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. The one who is far from a surat al-mustaqim. So I'm sorry, Mr. Devil, but I don't want to play on your team. So please kick me out your plans and all your evil, wicked schemes. Don't invite me to your parties or call me to disbelief, and I won't speak ill about my brothers, cause I know you love it when we beef. I was tricked by the devil, took a hold of me when I was weak. Now he's trying to be my homie, calling me with his deceit. And your Facebook requests I won't accept, I confess. One of the greatest tricks he ever played was to make the whole world think he didn't exist. But the fact is, he doesn't sleep or take sick days or leaves. So seek refuge in Allah from the accursed one, Iblis. And if he asks you for a ride, then you better say never, because a ride with the devil might last you forever.